For the Liberance and Moon and Rising, and I want to say to each and every person, thank you for your likes, shares, and support. This is positive. This is good situations. It is a month. I want to say thank you for being here. Thank you for being back. Thank you for the support, the likes and shares, you Liberance, and for all newcomers, welcome. Thank you. Please like and share these videos and remember to subscribe. Please remember to listen to the general readings because they're going to be up when these are being uploaded. And please like and share these videos. Please share these videos because it's very important that people understand what to expect in this month. This month energy is the energy of the Hangman in the upright form. That is a water energy. And you guys are a air sign and you have a fire sign. So most of you are working with fire sign. Most of you air people are working with fire sign. All of the three elements of air are working with a fire sign with water. So it's going to be an emotional time for you guys. And we are going to look in the month to see what is going to be transpiring. So let's look and let's call in the angels and guides and the universal beings who are protecting the Liberants to show them what is going to be the energies for this month of March. This month of March carries 5 weeks, so it's going to be a long month. The energy of the sun comes out, so this is wonderful for you Liberants. This is, you know, congratulations to be the first one who has the energy of the sun coming out, so this is going to be good. It's as if you guys have gone through a transition since last year coming in, and the energy of the sun is coming out, so wonderful positive things. I'm seeing a lot of people who were sick is going to be feeling better in the first week. If you have been going through a lot of situation, I'm seeing a lot of people who had health problems, it's going to start feeling better in the first week. Okay, I'm not a doctor, don't take this as it is. It's just that I'm seeing that people are going to be feeling much better and feeling upbeat. So this is going to be good. As we move forward, we're looking to see what is going to happen in the second week. A lot of success is coming in a lot for you Liberants. Okay, and that could be because the general energy is a lot of success coming in work and career. Second week, the Ace of Pentacles. Oh my gosh. Money, money, money for you Liberants coming in the second week. So this is going to be good. The Ace of Pentacles, your financial situation is going to be good. Balance, the Ace of Pentacles with the energy of the sun, a lot of money. So whatever you were doing, whatever you were trying to build, whatever it, your business, especially for the businessmen and women out there, if you have a business, your business is going to be looking up in the first and second week of March. So, you know, get ready for new clients. Information is going to be coming at you. Good information, information about money, information about connecting, information, business, a lot of business deals, business proposal is going to be coming in. For a lot of people, new work, if you're looking for new work, another information is going to be coming in. People are going to be coming in to help you with whatever it is that you need. In the fourth week, you have new love coming in. So, whoopee you, Liberants. This is wonderful because and I'm going to stop calling other signs. Because I keep on getting, is this a Pisces reading or a Scorpio or is this a Libra reading? But anyway, new love is coming in for you guys. And new love is coming in. If you are a lady out there looking for a man with money, he's going to be coming your way, darling. It's going to be coming your way, okay? Let's see what we have for the last week for the Liberants. You have the energy of the month of March. So you are finding out who you are. You are accepting who you are. And this is the energy of judgment because it's as if some of you were working on yourself to understand who you are, and the energy of the judgment comes out with the energy of the Hangman in reverse. So this is a positive month for you guys. New love, you are realizing that you maybe have met the love of your life, or you are looking forward to meet this person. A lot of success in business is going to come in. If you guys are working a freelance project, that sort of a thing, a lot of success is going to be coming in business for you Librans out there. So it's going to be wonderful. Good news. Good news is going to come in. So let's see how the month is going to play out to see what is happening. The energy of the sun, and this is wonderful because the Four of Swords is in reverse. So this is good. So it's as if you guys were in a resting period, and now the resting period is out. So again, for the people who have not been feeling well, this is going to be better for you because this is going to be wonderful. You are going to be feeling upbeat. If you were going through an illness and that sort of a thing, you're going to be feeling upbeat. Money is going to be coming in. A lot of people are going to be receiving promotions, promoted, accolades, which is, you know, a lot of you know, situation where people are seeing the work that you have been doing, and you know, this is just going to be wonderful and very, very, very good for you guys. So it's going to be wonderful. It's as if your luck is changing, and money is not going to be a problem in the second week. Third week to the second week, the energy of the Tower comes up. So whatever that was blocking your financial situation, you Librans, it's finally coming to an end. So if you Librans out there was having financial situation, information is going to come in and going to bring that finally to an end. So this is good because the energy of a judgment and the Tower is always that whatever that was blocking, because the Ace of Pentacles comes before the energy of judgment, whatever that was blocking your financial situation, it's now going to be released. There's a healing that is coming in because you have the energy of the Devil. So whatever that, you know, this energy was keeping you back with, your financial situation is going to be much better. It's going to be healed. Whatever that was blocking you is going to be released, and these blockage is going to be moving away, which is good. Let's look at the fourth and fifth weeks to see what is going to transpire, because we are seeing new love coming in, and you're finding your true inner self. And this is wonderful because when the energy of new love coming in, you have the energy of new love coming in with the energy of the High Princess. This is that the universal angels and guides, or your guiding angels or something, is going to clear up the communications. This could be new light beams that are coming in and working with some of you. And this is going to be good because if you are a very psychic person, or if you are someone who connects with a spirit world, they are going to be coming in and orchestrating and bringing new love in your life. For the people who have been dealing with situation, for the people who have been dealing with situations like health situation and that sort of a thing. Some of you have been dealing with, you know, sort of a health situation. If you were having headaches and this sort of a thing, because I don't do health, but this is good because the energy of the sun begins your month, which is very good, and you have the energy of water and the Devil. And why I don't do health situation is that sometimes you get these strange people saying, yeah, but you said that I will feel much better, that sort of a thing. I'm not a physician. I just I channel the message that is coming through. If there was a situation where you weren't aware of what was happening, you know, why am I not reading the right person? Am I going to ever meet the right person? New love is coming in, and it's as if you have gone through certain relationships, and now you are finally seeing that certain things, certain people don't match your energy vibration. You're going to accept it, and the High Princess is going to show you your way to who it is that is much better. First half of the week, whatever that was going on with your situation, it's going to be healed, because in the second week, a lot of you will be receiving money. Okay, so if you were having unbalance in your financial situation, your emotion, and that sort of a thing, this is going to be changing, and changing in a very, very positive way. So not to think about whatever is happening, this is going to be coming good. As we move on, we have another energy of the Three of Pentacles. So this is good for a lot of people, because you have the Two of Pentacles and the Three of Pentacles. And do not count this, the Five of Pentacles is going to be archetypal. No, because you have the Ace, the A of Pentacles, the Ace of Pentacles. So not to worry, because what this is saying is that if you had been having financial situation, the Ace of Pentacles is a new beginning, and that is in the second week. It's the new beginning of love coming in. So you have the two of Pentacles and the Three of Pentacles and the Eight, and this is going to be good, because what it's saying, because they're conjuncting with it's like the pyramid, and the Ace of Pentacles is at the top of the pyramid, and then you have the Two of Pentacles and the Three of Pentacles. So what is happening is that your financial situation is going to, if there was a blockage, whatever that was the blockage in your financial situation, it is going to be healed, and it is going to be good. Okay, so as I look at your month, it's going to be a very, very positive month. There's a lot of new beginning in love for a lot of people, a lot of new beginning in your health, which is very, very important, because as your energy is at a high, if your energy is very high, then this is going to be good, because what this is going to be doing is to make changes coming in your life. So new beginning with love is going to be there for you guys, which is wonderful, positive, good for you guys, because whoever you are that was having financial situation, there's going to be this new beginning in love that is coming in, and it's going to be wonderful new beginning in your financial situation for the people who has been going through hardship, and a new beginning in your health. I'm seeing as if you are being, you're no longer in the resting position. You are going to be, and I'm getting something, some people are going to find themselves either going to the hospital, to visit people in the hospital, and that sort of a thing. What is so beautiful with your reading is that you're not really dealing with, any zodiac energy, like other people. You're really, working on healing yourself, your money, and love, and this is wonderful. This is positive. Now I've changed up the readings, and we are going to be looking at the love energies, and we're first starting off with the latest over 50. Let's see what is coming in for the latest over 40. I'm sorry. The ladies over 40 are going to be connecting with someone who is a Taurus, Virgo, or a Capricorn, and this person has is very financial stable. So this is going to be good for you ladies. So you ladies over the age of 40, if you're not in a relationship, some of you who are with a Taurus, Virgo, or a Capricorn, this is going to be a good relationship, because your financial situation is going to be in balance. So this is going to be good for you ladies. As we move on, and we are looking at the energies for the men over 40, you are keeping your money to yourself. You're holding on to, it's as if you don't want to let go anything. It's as if you realize that, old women, you don't want to let out anything. It's like you're holding on and keeping things to yourself. You're not letting out anything. You're sort of in an observed position and holding everything to yourself, which meaning that you're not opening up. I'm seeing a lot of you men in relationships, and you don't want to open up to let the other person know how you're feeling. And for some of you are keeping secrets from your wife, and And yeah, I'm seeing this coming, and a lot of you are keeping secrets from your wife. So be aware of this because this can be coming out. Let's look at it. Young ladies, 18 till the princesses, 18 till the princesses, 18 to 25. You are, there's a rivalry that is coming in. Some of you are having a rivalry with someone who is Pisces, Cancer, or a Scorpion. So, if because you're looking out, it's as if you're not trusting a situation, and there's a rivalry with a princess. This is someone who is a Pisces, Cancer, or a Scorpion. And this person, be aware of this because you kind of have a feeling that there is someone else, and you're kind of watching and looking, in telephones and that sort of a thing. And trying to figure out who is this person, or there's a person in a group, or you realize that your partner is getting too close for comfort with this another person who's in your age group, which is 18 to the mid 30, and you're looking at this, and I am like this. I don't have any time for this. Don't get in this sort of a thing. If you feel that you are not trusting this person, find someone else, move on. And some people are like, yeah, it is easy for you to say, but I'm so in love with him. Listen, if he was so in love with you, he wouldn't be looking at someone else, okay? That's as far as I'm concerned. And I think it is so disrespectful for these men. You go out with them and their eyes is all over the place. I don't have any time for that. Bye. You want to be all over the place? Then you shouldn't be with me. That's how I look at things. For the men, and a lot of you, I should say this, a lot of you hair sign young men are thinking about work. You don't want to be in this love thing in this month. This love thing is not really coming up for you, guys, because it's as if you are focusing on building something in your life. Work is what you're focusing on. You are not focusing on love. It's as if you're putting love at the back burner in this month. So let's see what will come up for you guys in the next month. And this do happen, people. So it has nothing to do with, it's the energy vibrations are so changing. So this really do happen. So we are going to move on to the financial part of your reading. So let's see, and let's ask the angels what is coming up. It's already here, but I'm asking if there's any more messages for the financial part of your reading. You have got the sun twice. I'm not even going to go any further. You have the energy of the sun twice. You Librans, this is going to be a very good positive month, even though that you're working with this energy, which as a lot of people are going to be really craving for things that is not supposed to. But the energy of the sun comes up in your money sector, which is saying that whatever your financial situation was, whatever your financial disposable was, it's going to be good because you begin the month with the energy of the sun. And in your money section is the energy of the sun. And you have the Ace of Pentacles, and you have the Two of Pentacles and the Three of Pentacles. So, your money is going to be looking up. People who were having financial situation, it's going to be looking up. Business people who are working towards something, this is going to be good. You have nothing to worry and nothing to fear. So congratulations again. This is going to be a positive month for you guys. Let's move on and see what the energy of the vortex have for you Librans. What's the energy of the vortex have for you Librans? Wow, it's a beautiful reading, you Librans. It's a really wonderful reading. By your attention to things, you make choices. Isn't this beautiful? Yes, it's such a beautiful, beautiful card. So what people do not understand is that you do not choose some things by looking at it and it shows up. Yes, sometimes. You would like sometimes that things you just think of them and then, but you make your own choices by the attention to things. In the universe, that is based on attraction. When you look at an unwanted thing, you're attracted it into your life, and you cause this to activate your vibration with it. And the law of attraction brings more likely things into your experience. And and this is it. And this is why I said to people, try and have positive thoughts because, trust me, the last time, whatever you're thinking about, that is what you're going to be bringing in your existence. So be positive. And you have a magnificent, this is so wonderful. It is what your month is all about because the energy of the sun with the energy of the sun with the Ace of Pentacles, this is just grand. This is fantastic. You do not have to worry about anything in this month. Heal whatever is going on, and you will be okay. We're going to look at the zodiac and the last energy, the zodiac aspect of this month. We're going to look at the zodiac aspect of this month. You have the energy of Scorpion, energy of the Scorpion, and I'm seeing here a lot of you. There's a little jealousy that is good. Your enemies are coming, or your enemies are there. They are there, but they can't pounce upon you this in this month. Scorpion, you guys are going to be dealing with some Scorpion energies, and it can be people who have Scorpion sun, moon, and rising sign. And whatever this energy is, whatever is happening, whatever that is transpiring with these energies that you have to deal with these Scorpion people, they can be helping you to see your enemies, so they can be helping you to see your enemies. So whatever the situation and however they come in your life, just try to deal with them in whatever way, because you have a very good month. Some of you will be connecting to the Scorpion, so this is going to be a positive month to heal certain aspects and certain things. I want to say to you guys, namaste, until next month.